Here we're asked to graph x equals y squared minus y minus 6. Now the first thing I notice is that this is quadratic in y. That tells us that the graph will be a sideways parabola. Now since the leading coefficient is 1, that's positive, we know that this sideways parabola is going to open to the right. Let's begin by finding the x-intercept. Now to find the x-intercept, we set y equal to 0. So in this case, we have x equals 0 squared minus 0 minus 6. In other words, x equals negative 6. And so that tells me the x-intercept will be negative 6 comma 0. Next, let's find the y-intercepts. And to find the y-intercepts, we set x equal to 0. So in this case, we have 0 equals y squared minus y minus 6, which is quadratic, and it does factor. If we write y and 2 and 3, we'll have a negative 1y if the 3 is negative here and the 2 is positive. And then set each factor equal to 0. And that gives us two answers, y equals negative 2 or y equals 3. And so that tells us we have two y-intercepts, one at 0 comma negative 2 and another at 0 comma 3. Now finally, we want to find the vertex. And to do that here, we will use vertex form. Recall, vertex form is x equals a times the quantity y minus k squared plus h. If we can write the original equation in that form, then the vertex will simply be h comma k. Now to do that, we'll begin by making room for the constant that completes the square. So we'll be adding some number and then at the same time subtracting the same exact number. Now the number that completes the square, remember, is b over 2 squared. So in this case, b is negative 1. So negative 1 over 2 squared gives us 1/4. And so that's the number we're going to use to complete the square. We'll add 1/4 and subtract 1/4 to the right side of the equation and then factor this resulting trinomial here. And in this case, we get, well, we should always get a perfect square. So we have y times y, 1/4 factors as 1/2 times 1/2, and adds up to negative 1y here if they're both negative. Now negative 1/4 minus 6 adds up to negative 25/4. And so we have x equals y minus 1/2 squared minus 25/4. And we have vertex form. In this form we can read the vertex. Let me take an extra step to be absolutely clear. Y minus 1/2, 1/2 will be the k squared, plus negative 25/4. Okay, so here we can see then that the vertex, the h comma k in this case, is negative 25/4 comma 1/2. Okay, once we have our x and y intercepts and our vertex, we're ready to graph this. Okay, so remember we found the x-intercept to be at negative 6 comma 0. And then we found the y-intercepts, one at, excuse me, let me fix this, 0 comma negative 2 and 0 comma 3, right? Get those reversed. Okay, so 0 comma negative 2 is here, and 0 comma 3 is there. Now, the vertex we found was negative 25 fourths, or negative 6 and a quarter, comma 1 half. So negative 6 and a quarter is about right there. Let's go ahead and label that. And then finally, we can see that there'll be a point of symmetry here at negative 6, comma 1. Okay, so now we're ready to sketch this sideways parabola. And so here we have a rough sketch of x equals y squared minus y minus 6.